Your Excellencies, Mr. President and Madam First Lady of Kenya, Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Whilst preparing for this summit, I could not reflect on how the world would today look if 25 years ago the International Conference on Population Development was not held and the program of action was not agreed upon. What would the status of women and girls be? How would the health of women and girls look around the world? What would global development, social, economic, environmental, look like? No one can answer that question, but one thing is for sure. We cannot return to a time when women had little say in reproductive issues, or for that matter, in areas, in any area of their lives. I think we can all agree that ICBD was a turning point, a defining moment in our history. In Cairo, the world articulated a bold new vision about the relationship between population, development, and individual well-being, and the empowering of women and meeting people's needs for education and health, including sexual and reproductive health, are necessary for both individual advancement and balanced development. And I think we can all agree and be thankful for that in 1994, we stood united on such a visionary and common agenda, an agenda that paved the way for a more just, prosperous, and sustainable future, an agenda that acknowledged that people, women and men, mothers and fathers, were the best judges, guided by knowledge and access in terms of how many children to bring into the world, if to have children, and the spacing of them. The desired outcome of ICBD was to give choice to the individual. And choice is very powerful. This milestone has fundamentally shaped the lives of women and men and families and the societies in which they live. It has contributed to reducing poverty and hunger and improving education and health globally. More girls are attending and completing an education. Fewer are getting married or becoming mothers while still children themselves. And more are gaining the skills they need to excel in the future world of work. So in reality, the ICBD program of action was not just a win for the individual and for families. It was in fact a precious gift to the entire world, a gift that can keep on giving. Therefore, I'm so happy to be here to celebrate 25 years of ICBD. And as we do so, it is important to reflect on what has been achieved, understand how the achievements have been made, where the challenges lie in achieving full implementation of the program of action, and to better understand the underlying societal complexities and structures that fail to respect women's physical integrity so that we can bridge the gaps. One question that I keep asking myself is, why is it so hard to move forward on this agenda? An agenda that, to me, is fair and just, and would seem to be the most natural path toward human and societal development. Well, sexual and reproductive health and rights are not always easy to deal with or talk about. Quite the contrary. Many perceive them as controversial, as being private. They relate to intimacy and emotions. They are issues that are often governed by discriminatory laws and deeply rooted social norms and practices. I understand that these matters are surrounded by privacy or even taboo, and there exist those that are not in agreement with some or many of the principles and rights otherwise agreed upon in Cairo. That is a reality, and one that needs to be addressed. Addressed through better understanding of the position and the sensitivities behind opposing viewpoints and the binding roles of social norms. Open dialogue and discussion. Relooking at the narrative. How do we talk about these issues? And how do we provide safe places to really hear what women and girls are trying to tell us? We need to ensure a stronger evidence-based approach for investment and implementation. And we need to engage a whole of society approach to decision-making and policy development. Not an easy task by any stretch of the imagination, but amazing things can be achieved when we join together, despite our differences, when imagining a world we want. Everyone has a role to play in achieving the promise of Cairo. Youth, governments, politicians, civil society, academia, the private sector, role models, parents, yeah, people. Real and lasting change requires enough people seeing enough people making change and benefiting from it. In my role as patron for UNFPA for now almost a decade, I've had the privilege to meet people of different age, gender, background, and culture. Young girls and boys, women and men from around the world. Every single meeting, every single conversation, every single life story that I have heard has reinforced for me, without doubt, that the importance of knowledge, the power of choice, and that the empowerment of women is key to improving life for all. I've always refused to see women as victims, but at the same time, I must acknowledge that we are more vulnerable in certain situations, such as in humanitarian crisis. However, vulnerability is not an expression of weakness. It is an expression of inequality and of the unique needs and role that women have, quite simply have, just because they are women. Women's resourcefulness and willingness to help, even when facing hardship, their hope under hopeless conditions, and their initiative when options seem limited is a strength that must not go untapped. 25 years ago in Cairo, we knew that protecting and ensuring the rights of women and girls was a promise worth making, a promise worth keeping, and it held the promise of a better future for all. Now, we're taught from an early age to never promise more than we can deliver. I believe that the intention has always been to deliver, but today the promise remains unfulfilled and in corners challenged. Here in Nairobi, as we as a global community have an opportunity to reaffirm that promise, find new ways to deliver on it, and earn respect for keeping that promise. Let us use our learnings and knowledge gained in the past 25 years. Let us use the SDG framework where the Cairo Promise is integrated. Let us look to new and innovative partnerships to bridge gaps. Let us engage the youth respectfully and fully. And let us commit to overcoming differences and taboos to ensure rights and choices for all. Let us provide the knowledge, means, and services to ensure protection, dignity, and self-determination in the most intimate and all-important aspects of human life. The only way forward, in my view, is the full realization of reproductive rights. For every individual and couple, no matter who they are, where they live, or what they have. Now is the time to fulfill the promise, to secure the rights, choices, and dignity of all. And as I see it, it is the most natural thing in the world to do. Thank you.